That's the fastest lap so far. Well done.
Good day today. Let's have your take on it. You won't be starting at the front of the pack. Are you worried? How do you feel about this team's performance this season? You left some bodywork out there on the track. Appreciate your time.
Welcome along then to the place where heroes and history are made. It's where the 2008 title was decided in the final corner. And it's the place, a year later, that Jenson Button stormed through from 14th on the grid to claim his one and only Drivers' Championship. It's Interlagos, and it's time for the Brazilian Grand Prix.
Interlagos, always a very special race here in Brazil. It's a 2.7-mile circuit with 9 lefts and 6 rights for a total of 15 corners. But it's a wet one today, so grip and visibility will be at a premium. The drivers will need to be careful coming up the hill in Sector 3, the scene of many an accident over the years.
Joining us today to oversee all the thrills and spills, it's Anthony Davidson. Ant, great to see you. How are you feeling about the race today, and how are the circuit conditions from what you've seen?
Well, it's looking a bit cold out there, if I'm honest. These tyres have quite a narrow operating window in terms of the temperatures they need to extract the best grip. So with a cold track surface, it's going to be harder to keep those temperatures up, which will lead to lower grip and maybe more mistakes.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. A very happy Carlos Sainz will start second. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Norris, Bottas, Pierre Gasly and Leclerc, Perez, Ricciardo, Stroll and Nobuharu Matsushita, Vettel, Russell, Antonio Giovinazzi and Tsunoda, Moore, Latifi, Mick Schumacher. They've taken a grid penalty. And Esteban Ocon, Joe, and Nikita Mazepin. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
Okay, we need a good result today if we want to catch Verstappen in the Drivers' Championship. The virtual safety car has just been deployed due to a build-up of stopped cars on the track. Watch your pace. Okay, slow down, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. There have been further incidents out on the track, so the officials are moving to a full safety car. Okay, the safety car is coming in this lap. We'll be pacing the field in sector 3. Make sure to respect the delta until the safety car is in the pit lane. Green flag. We're leading our teammate by 1.9 seconds. Three wins in a row. Unbelievable work.
That's a fantastic performance from Ferrari. It hardly looked in doubt. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, keeping their tyre temperatures up in the tricky wet conditions was really important. There's not much grip out there at the best of times, and it's 10 times worse if you're out there on cold tyres. So the way they kept the rubber in its proper operating window was a huge advantage today.
Looking at the podium, you can see that red suit familiar to fans across the globe. A world-class win for a world-class team. Ferrari, do it again. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Our championship leader is still sat at the top of the standings, but their rivals have made up some solid ground today. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
I have to give it to Moore. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. No change in the top spot, but with today's points, their hold on the lead is getting weaker. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to join us again as we continue to bring you the latest excitement in Formula One.